winds in the east. Mist coming in. Like something is brewing. About to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are beginning our descent into Los Angeles.
Welcome, Mrs. P.L. Travers, to the City of Angels.
It smells like...
jasmine.
Chlorine. And sweat.
Introducing the creator of our beloved Mary.
Poppins. Never ever just Mary.
Now, where is Mr. Disney?
She's here.
Well, Pamela Travers. You can't imagine how excited I am to finally meet you.
Would you mind? My name is Mrs. Travers, Mr. Disney.
Oh, Walt, now you gotta call me Walt. 20 years ago, I made a promise to my daughters that I would make your Mary Poppins fly off the pages of your books. I promised them, Pam.
I know what he's going to do to her. She'll be cavorting and twinkling.
He can't play the film unless you grant the rights.
Damn.
Ideas.
What kind of ideas?
Responsible. Responsible.
No. Responsible is not a word.
We made it up.
Well, unmake it up.
You won't approve Dick Van Dyke.
No.
The Lentis house doesn't look like that. No,
it's all wrong.
It's all wrong.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Stop. Mary Poppins is not for sale. I won't have her turned into one of your silly cartoons.
Says the woman who sent a flying nanny with a talking umbrella to save the children.
You think Mary Poppins has come to save the children? Oh, dear.
Mr. Travers, what am I missing here? I'm wondering what I have to do to make you happy. You know, you've never been to Disneyland, and that's the happiest place on Earth.
No, please.
Well, when does anybody get to go to Disneyland with Walt Disney himself?
There he is.
Where did she come from?
Mary Poppins and the Bankses. They're family to me.
Mary Poppins was a real person? So it's not the children she comes to save. It's their father. It's your father.
You don't know what she means to me.
I won't disappoint you. I swear every time a person walks into a movie house, they will rejoice. Don't you want to finish the story? The boys have come up with an idea. I think it's going to make you happy.
You didn't bring me all the way here to tell me that.
Oh, no. I had a wager. I couldn't get you on a ride. I just won $20.
Yeah! I feel bad because I know that so many of you are excited about this trailer and I got so many requests to cover it, but I have to say, I personally really hate it. And I pretty much really hate it just for one reason, and that reason is Tom Hanks. I think he is just horribly miscast. You know, when we first saw that pencil mustache that he grew during production, it looked somewhat promising. But now that I see it in action, I'm actually kind of offended because I feel he is so unlike Walt Disney that it's like he's not even trying. I mean, what's with the southern accent he seems to have? That makes like no sense whatsoever. Walt Disney had not anywhere near a southern accent. He had a Midwestern accent. You know, kind of like, I guess, the one that Daniel Day-Lewis did in Lincoln. You know, kind of that kind of an Americana tone of voice. But Tom Hanks doesn't look like Walt Disney, he doesn't sound like Walt Disney, he doesn't move like Walt Disney. Basically, they just surrounded him with Walt Disney stuff and were hoping it would kind of rub off on him. But anyone who's a fan of Walt Disney knows the magic started with him. And I am a big fan of Walt Disney. I went through a period of time when, you know, I read everything I could find about him. And a lot of people do that, I think, you know, trying to find the man behind the mouse. But I also think that a lot of people, while digging to get to the heart of the matter, they eventually all come to a point where they are like, it's not so great. It's like you realize that Walt Disney was human and had some very deep flaws. And it looks like they're exploring that here, so I give them points for that. But also, that said, also on a side note, I feel that as funny as Jason Schwartzman and I forget his exact name, but the guy from The Office might be, they don't look anything like the Sherman Brothers either. I feel like almost the movie cast people they felt people would be excited to see, audiences would be excited to see, but that it looked nothing like the original people. It's like, well, who doesn't want to see Jason Schwartzman and this other guy get into some hijinks? And who doesn't love Tom Hanks? He's so warm and fuzzy. That it's like nobody stopped to think, well, he looks nothing absolutely at all like Walt Disney. And it's interesting because, you know, this is a trend in Hollywood right now where they do a biography where they don't tell someone's whole life, but they pick like a short period of time in that person's life, usually towards the end of their career, and they're like, oh, let's see what it was like then, and that'll give you a window inside the person. And I guess I could see why someone would pick Mary Poppins because it was one of Walt Disney's biggest hits for the studio, and also a lot of technological advancements were made for the film. It was certainly inarguably a pivotal point for Walt Disney and his studio. That said, if you're going to pick one period in Walt Disney's life, why wouldn't you pick that famous train ride that he took from New York to Los Angeles after he lost Oswald the Lucky Rabbit to his distributor in a legal snafu that just basically screwed him over, and he was so distraught that on that train ride he came up with Mickey Mouse. And a French artist was making like movie posters, you know, fantasy movie posters a while ago, maybe a year or so ago. And the one that got the most attention was he cast Ryan Gosling as a young Walt Disney. And the scene that he depicted on the poster was that train ride of Walt Disney coming up with Mickey Mouse. And see, that movie is, I think, what everybody wants to see. And I think, you know, my hunch is that people get excited about this because they're hoping to get that. But I don't see that here. You know, and Ryan Gosling not only looks like Walt Disney, but, you know, if you think back to the voice he did in Gangster Squad, the high-pitched kind of nasally voice, you can see him doing, like, the voice for Mickey Mouse, which Walt did at first. So I'm sure it looks very colorful. I love seeing Disneyland. You know, it's funny to see that Paul Giamatti is the driver and go, oh, look, there's Walt Disney standing there to take you on the tour himself. But, you know, I guess Walt was trying to put on a show. But, you know, from what I've seen of Walt Disney, he didn't come to Disneyland and try and be the center of attention, you know. There are tons of stories about people just being like, not even noticing that Walt was sitting next to them like on a bench at Disneyland. So, I mean, I don't know, I'm just so and I also feel that, you know, this movie is more of a current Hollywood biography, that trend, My Week with Marilyn, Finding Neverland, The Grace of Monaco that's coming out. The Hitchcock, you know, the one they did with, you know, Hitchcock making Psycho. I feel that that is more in that mold than in the mold of trying to tell the story of Walt Disney or even Mary Poppins. I feel this movie is like, I can really see, you know, the strings being pulled to try and be like Oscar contender. I don't know. And it's from the Disney company itself. I'm very unhappy with it. So those are my thoughts on it. I hope that you can see where I'm coming from, and also write down below why you like the trailer so much. But I know some of you are also on the fence, and some of you weren't quite sure why. So also let me know if I've helped explain maybe why the trailer doesn't seem to click with you. So lots of trailer reviews coming today, real fast. Some today, maybe some tomorrow as well. I have to get out of the office. I hope you enjoy them, and write your comments down below. Bye.